I am going to be reacting to prequels haters, oh no.
This is the first video and I am absolutely terrified to what this guy is going to say. Top 5 things the Star Wars prequels did horribly wrong. Let's hear what he has to say. Whoa. Already, first swear word, my gosh. We're only 2 seconds in. This man.
More than life itself, but
Whoa, wait. No, this guy is like absolutely like hating this. So let's see what you mean.
Why? What makes them so bad?
They're not bad. They're much better in my opinion than any of the two other trilogies, I'm pretty sure.
I hate these movies with such a passion that I find it difficult to put thoughts to words on why they're so completely and utterly wrong. Well, clearly there are a lot of reasons as to why, but let's boil it down into the 5 major things that ultimately are the reason that these films-
That is insane. No, I disagree.
Hey,
language, bro. Special effects.
Special effects are just a tool, a means of telling a story. People have a tendency to confuse them as an end to themselves. A special effect without a story is a pretty boring thing.
Wait, did he just forget that he said that or what? It's pretty ironic that the original films from 30 years ago actually hold up better and are more convincing than the sickening, sleek, fake, clean-looking prequels.
Look, the truth is, look, I gotta be honest. I'm gonna be completely honest. It was 1999 when The Phantom Menace came out. Calm down. Because if you call the prequels VFX bad, look at DC's VFX. They are absolute garbage. And I don't even think I have to show you guys any clips of them. Because, oh my, they're dangerous.
This isn't Star Wars. This is Star Wars. I'm not sure if it was through pure-
Hold up, wait a minute. What did you just call not-
Wars? This isn't Star Wars.
Look.
This is Star Wars. I'm not sure if it was through pure laziness or just because Lucas wanted to push the boundaries of special effects, but the end result just doesn't work. Some of the effects look so bad now that they make you physically cringe.
This movie came out in 1999. Shut your mouth, bro.
Bad. Nothing feels real, and it makes the already stupid story appear even more bare and like a cheap cartoon.
Bro,
I mean, look at this
stop.
Piss-poor compositing of the clone trooper's real face onto-
What did you just say? I remind you, the prequels gave you the first time you ever see Yoda use a lightsaber. It gave us a very much more energetic Yoda. I don't understand why you wouldn't like
Yoda. He reveals that he's the most powerful Jedi in the universe, teaching Luke to not judge a book by its cover. They're my favorite scenes from the movies. Too bad Lucas clearly doesn't understand what makes Yoda work so well. Instead assuming that everyone wanted to see him fight with a mini green-
Let me tell you something that's very funny. About this, everyone wanted to see Yoda fight. Everyone wanted to see him fight with that lightsaber. Like, everyone wanted to know. I swear to God. It was true, though. A lot of people liked that. And I don't understand why you're
mad. Fling around like a frog. Why would he even use a lightsaber?
First of all, you're the one who's insulting Yoda, so I don't understand what's your point.
A Jedi uses the Force for knowledge and defense, never for attack.
Look, I don't think he knows, really. I can understand his point there, but the truth is, the thing is, the only reason why technically Yoda is attacking is to save someone's life. I mean, if someone was gonna shoot, like, your best friend or something, would you not go, like, attack? Would you not? Would you just let them go be there and just, like, kill them? No! Well, unless you're a very much backstabber type of friend. This man is, like, just ruining everything for me.
Like that being trained by Yoda is actually completely boring and uninteresting.
You just called kids stupid. But you know what? Do you know what's so funny? I'm pretty sure that Yoda said that Luke was, like, too old to be trained. And so does he say to, like, he also says that to Anakin. So I think that, in my opinion, it makes sense that he would train very young kids before they get too old.
Or use those stupid robots. As if ruining Yoda, Boba Fett, Darth Vader, Obi-Wan, Jabba, C-3PO, R2-D2, and lightsabers wasn't enough. We also had to have one of the most magical parts of Star Wars utterly destroyed by a pointless over-explanation of the Force. The prequels again to refresh myself for this video, it became immediately apparent that nearly every scene has a new type of creature or vehicle, purely so it could be sold as a toy. You wanted a Millennium Falcon because it was so awesome, not because they awkwardly and pointlessly crammed it into one shot from a forgettable scene. No.
The reason why I can understand what he's saying, I mean, some people do forget that George Lucas did not direct those two movies, but what I love about A New Hope, it's just a good film. It's good. What I do not like about Empire is that they made us wait like 3 years to actually know what was going on. That's so annoying. And in my opinion, The Empire Strikes Back is like my least favorite film out of all of the original trilogy. That might be controversial, but it's true. And I just like, it just is a tick in me that says that it's the worst. I don't know why. Why do I have to blur out what he put right here? What is this, bro? What are you doing with your life? And, let's just continue. Oh my. Feel like the amount of things he's just said, I want to report him. I do not understand why you hate them. In my opinion, I like them, actually. So, nice job, buddy. Very, very, very nice.